Hello.
Brian? It's Laura.
Laura? What time is it?
It's a little bit after 2. I didn't wake you, did I?
No, I'm always up around 2 o'clock. Hey, what's happening? What's going on?
Have you seen Scotty? I just called the apartment. There's no answer there.
There's no answer there? Where are you?
I'm still at the disco.
At this hour?
Well, Scotty was supposed to pick me up over an hour ago. I guess he just decided not to.
Oh, look, what kind of fool talk is that?
Oh, well, you know us, Brian. We had another little quarrel this morning. I just don't think he's ever going to talk to me again.
Oh, come on. It can't be as bad as all that.
Well, that's why I've been waiting. He left a message saying that he wanted to see me.
Oh, then he'll be there.
Yeah, you're right. I'm sure he's on his way.
Look, I'll go upstairs to the apartment, leave a note, and I'll come up there and pick you up myself.
No, Brian, no. I want to wait for Scotty.
Look, are you sure? Look, it won't be any trouble.
I'm sure. Look, if our marriage is going to work, I've got to believe that he'll show up. He promised he would, and he doesn't break his promises. Listen, I'm really sorry for waking you up, but why don't you just go back to sleep now, okay?
All right. But look, if he doesn't show up there soon, you call me back. You hear?
I hear. Bye, Brian.
Bye-bye.
Where could you be? I feel absolutely safe when I'm in your arms.
Tonight's a perfect night for us.
Mm-hmm. It is. It's perfect.
I don't think there's anything in this whole world that can spot.
Thank you.
Luke? Luke, what's wrong?
Go away, Laura. Get out of here.
I can't go away and leave you like this.
Go home, Laura, please.
No, I won't.
Your husband will be waiting for you.
Luke, don't you think maybe you feel like talking about it, you know? I mean, I'm a really good listener.
No, thank you.
You look about like I feel. Scotty was supposed to pick me up at 1 o'clock.
It's almost 2:30.
You look like you lost your best friend. I think that I lost mine. I think my marriage is over, Luke.
He's not that much of a fool, Laura. He'll never let you go.
Oh, but you don't know what a terrible quarrel we had. He...
What, just because you bought him some law books with a credit card? Just because you gave him something that very few people have? Love?
Oh, because I lied to him. But using that credit card, why couldn't I tell him the truth? I mean, then he would have been angry with me, yeah, but he wouldn't feel so betrayed. I don't believe how selfish I am. Look at you. And here I am, just rattling off all of my problems.
I understand.
Luke, where is Scotty?
Why don't we call him?
I have. I called his office, I called the apartment, and I even called Brandon, and I can't find him anywhere. Where could he be?
You know, I don't know. I guess all marriages are rocky sometime.
Is this a confession?
As a matter of fact, I had a fight with my wife this morning. She bought me a whole set of law books.
You quarreled over that? Any lawyer would kill for his own set. I don't even have my own
set. No, Zelle, wait, you don't understand. You see, we're on this budget, right? And she used the credit card that they sent us in the mail that we agreed we were not going to use.
I see.
But I owe her an apology. Wait a minute. Do you realize how late it is? I gotta get going.
Oh, no, she's not waiting up for you, is she?
No, I hope she's not waiting up for me. No, you see, the thing is, I was supposed to pick her up tonight, but because of what came up, I couldn't. However, I got a message to her through her sister, so everything should be all right.
No, this one's on me.
Well, I would have had two then.
Figures, Scott.
Zelda? I'll see you later, then. Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Goodbye.
Luke? How come you're crying?
I wasn't crying.
Yes, you were. When you didn't know that I was here. Luke, you've always been there for me. Why won't you treat me like that kind of a friend?
I don't want you involved, Laura.
Please, Luke, I want to help you.
You can't.
Luke, I'm sure that whatever it is, it can be worked out in time.
Time is what I don't have.
I understand.
No, you wouldn't. See, I found something out tonight. Within the month, I'll be dead.
Luke, what do you mean in a month you're gonna be dead? You're not sick, are you?
It's nothing that simple.
Will you stop playing games with me?
Look! This is no game. I wish it were. My life is over, Laura. And there's nothing I can do about it.
Anyone ever tell you not to leave your door open?
What is this I see?
Would you please leave?
You're really angry?
I'll call the police, Joe.
Man, this is ridiculous.
You are the one that's being ridiculous.
Me?
Yes, you. I mean, you know everything about me, Joe.
Oh, you like baseball.
Nothing. Yeah. Absolutely nothing about you.
Blue is your favorite
Joe
color.
Kelly, private detective.
You love the bagpipes.
Except, of course, you play...
You're beautiful when you're angry.
You study law in the evening. That is when you're not chasing women all over Port Charles. By day and night. Well?
Was there a question somewhere in there?
Oh, no, of course not.
You're really serious?
You make me so mad. And what's so funny?
You are little Annie Logan, you are.
Oh, I am, of course.
You know, if I didn't know any better, I'd say that you like me.
Like you?
Just a little bit, round the edges.
I am furious with you.
If you didn't care for me, you wouldn't get so mad.
Well, hey, what's going on around here?
Jeremy.
Can't I get any sleep?
Well, you see what you've done. You see what you've done, Jay.
Oh,
Jeremy, I'm sorry that Joe woke you up with his yelling.
Well, all I could hear was you.
Well, I'll take you up to bed right now, okay?
Okay, but I know I'm going to be missing something good.
And as for you, Mr. Joe Kelly, I am not through with you yet. Although I don't know why. I wouldn't care if you were the last man left on Earth. Come on.
Bye,
Come on.
Joe.
Well, did you not hear of Kate Kearney, who lived on the banks of Killarney?
Luke? Luke, I'm sure it can't be as bad as you think.
Laura, don't, please.
Your life isn't over.
Don't you hear me? I said I was going to be dead, killed, little lady. What's the matter? Can't you get that through your head? Now get out of here.
Luke, I don't know what you're talking about, but we are your friends.
Please don't. Don't.
And whatever problems you have, they can be worked out. Now, if somebody is after you or something, we can get the police.
The police? Leave it to you to think of that.
Luke, please don't drink. It's not going to solve anything.
I need this drink.
Okay. But look, let us help you. Anything can be worked out. Really.
You're incredible. Do you know that? I really think you should go home now.
No. I'm your friend, and I won't leave you here like this.
That's always been the trouble, you know? You never could. And you didn't know. You've never known where I was coming from, have you?
I know. I know that you care about me.
Damn it, Laura. I'm in love with you.
No, I don't think it's really love, Luke.
Yes. Yes, that's what it is. And it's like some kind of sickness inside me. It's eating me up. I can't concentrate on anything. And in my business, that's dangerous, baby. You got me between two worlds that don't mix.
I don't know what you're talking about, but I think I better...
That's right. You can't understand it. Why can't you understand me, Laura? I know why. Because you have Scotty. Do you know what it does to me? To know that you're in his bed every night. Do you know that all I care about is holding you? I need you. All I do is dream about you. I dream about holding you in my arms and making love to you. Laura, you are my life.
I'm sorry. I didn't know. Luke, I think I should quit my job here.
No.
Luke. Luke, my life with Scotty is all that I want right now, okay? Now, I know that you feel like your life is falling apart right now, and I'm sorry. But we can help you, Scotty, and I are your friends.
Don't say that ever again, okay? Look, I don't want to be your friend, Laura. I don't want to be your friend, and I can't have you. You don't belong in my world. I don't belong in yours. Look what you've done to me. I'm not not going to die without holding you in my arms just one time. Dance with me, Laura.
No.
I said, dance with me. I'm not such a bad guy.
No, I wouldn't say you're a bad guy. No.
I'm not trying to rush you.
I know.
We have all the time in the world. I just want to be able to show you how much I love you, girl. And that's... Well, that's not too much to ask, is it?
No. It's not too much to ask at all. Look, I have to go now. Look, let me call a taxi, please. You're frightening. No. No. Oh, Luke, let me go. No.
Hello?
Hi, it's Leslie.
Oh, hi. How are you?
You just getting in?
Yeah, I just walked in the door.
If I can be a prying parent just for a moment, how are you and Laura?
I guess she told you about our fight.
Well, she was very upset. She was afraid she was losing you.
Well, we haven't talked yet. I think she must be asleep right now. I couldn't pick her up from work because of the Kikorian lawsuit. But I'm going to talk to her in the morning, and I am going to apologize. I mean, I was way out of line with this whole law book deal. I should never have yelled at her the way I did.
Ah, I'm glad to hear you say that. She loves you desperately, you know.
Yeah, I know that, and it was stupid. It was stupid, you know, the way I reacted like that.
Well, we all say things sometimes that we shouldn't. But then when you get right down to it, she shouldn't have broken her promise about using the credit card.
Yeah. Well, listen, thanks for your concern.
We love you both. Give her a kiss for me, okay?
I will. Goodbye.
Bye.
Laura? Laura? Listen, I can't find Laura.
Scotty, what did you say?
I said it's Laura. I don't know where she is, and I don't know what to do.
Scotty, look, just calm down. Now, what do you mean? She's not home?
After I talked to Leslie, I went into the bedroom, but she's not there. And the bed hasn't been touched, and I called the disco, and I don't know what, you know, I don't know what to do.
All right, look, we'll be right over. I'm sure we'll find her. Call the police and alert them, and check to see if there have been any accidents. But, Scotty, just try to stay calm, all right?
Rick, will you hurry, please? All right, the police. Officer, her name is Laura Baldwin. That's Laura Weber Baldwin. She's blonde. 17. No, this has never happened before. All right. You're gonna call me, right? Okay. Goodbye. Hello. Is this the campus disco?
Yeah.
Luke, this is Scotty. Is Laura there? She's not at home.
Laura?
Is she there?
No, Laura isn't here, Scotty. She's gone.
Do you know where she went? I mean, where did she go?
She was waiting for you. And she left. I don't know what time it was.
Have you been there all night?
Yeah. Scotty, I'm working on my books.
Look, thanks anyway.
Oh, my God. What have I done?